Welcome to The Shoot. I'm Brandon Chin from Canon USA, and I heard that you're interested in shooting virtual reality. Well, today, I'll show you just how easy it is with the EOS R5 camera body and the RF5.2mm F2.8L dual fisheye lens. I've set up some example scenes that we're going to capture in stereoscopic 3D 180 degree VR. So if you're ready to check it out, let's go. We're at this beautiful home to show off how virtual reality really transports the viewer to another location. Today's scenes simulate a wedding shoot, but the potential of VR is as limitless as your creativity. From narrative stories, to concerts, to sports, and even travel, your imagination is the only limit. So you may be asking yourself, what does stereoscopic 3D 180 degree VR mean? Well, stereoscopic just means taking two images of the same scene from slightly different perspectives, just like how our eyes work in normal human vision. This creates an immersive 3D effect. 180 degree VR means that the viewer can look around 180 degrees within the VR environment. For example, look at this. Here's a scene shot through a traditional lens. The viewer only sees what I point the camera at. As the filmmaker, I have total control of where I direct their attention. Okay, let's look at that again, but this time, in stereoscopic 3D 180 degree VR, follow along in headset or pan around. Did you see that? More was happening there in that scene than what we saw the first time around. Now you're getting the idea of how storytelling works in VR. A big difference is that this time, you, the viewer, had control of where to look.
Do we have any more champagne?
Let's dive in and talk gear. Here's what's on the gear menu for VR basics today. The EOS R5 camera body, the RF 5.2mm F2.8L dual fisheye lens, a tripod, a horizontal arm, a ball head, a small sandbag for counterbalance and safety, and of course, memory cards. The higher the resolution that you set your camera to, the more immersive it will be. But remember, that also means more data. So always pack plenty of fast memory cards in your bag. Also, before shooting VR, be sure to upgrade your firmware for the EOS R5 camera body to version 1.5.0 or later. That adds some special VR tools, which we'll get to next. Because the field of view of this lens is so wide, we wanted to make it easy for you to frame up your shots and know what the viewer first sees. So we added the magic window. It's this white framing guide that you can access simply by pressing the info button. We also added the magnify function, allowing you to magnify each side of the lens independently. Simply press the magnify button to go from 6x magnification to 15x magnification. Press the info button to switch to the opposite side to check it as well. You can use manual focus peaking while magnified to provide a color overlay for your focus field. All right, let's get moving. I'll clean up because you don't have hands. You're probably wondering, with a lens this wide, how do you mount it? On most VR shoots, when you're starting out, you want the camera to remain very still. So a tripod is important. Even slight movements can make your viewer feel uneasy, and that's never good. But because the lens has that extreme wide angle, the tripod legs might be in your shot. So we're using this horizontal center column to extend the camera and the lens forward so that you won't see them. But because the camera is extended outward, having a good counterbalance weight will also stabilize your tripod for safety. Now, let's make sure that we're level. Using the info button, we're able to pull up that built-in electronic level, and adjusting the tripod legs will do the trick. Lastly, when you're picking your shot, if you're outside, make sure that the camera's positioned either 100% in the sun or 100% in the shade, not half and half. Otherwise, you may get some unwanted lens flares, also known as a visual disparity. Check for this on the LCD screen or using the remote live view screen on Camera Connect app or EOS Utility. Now let's get back to that ceremony.
I, John,
take thee, Victoria.
Take thee, Victoria.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
Let's look at the menu items to adjust inside the red shoot menu and the magenta autofocus menu. Let's start with the shoot menu. For this lens, capturing at 8K DCI or 4K DCI is recommended. choosing DCI over UHD won't crop the sides of your frame, giving you a fully captured image circle. When deciding on 8K or 4K, always consider the deliverables and balance those needs with your computing, storage, and processing capabilities. Today, let's use manual movie mode, 8K DCI at 2997p, and all eye recording. Our shutter speed is going to be double our frame rate, 1/60th of a second, and we'll typically shoot from around f5.6 to around f11. Lastly, we'll be shooting Canon log. When shooting a log exposure, always consider what the base ISO is and work around that to provide the most dynamic range. Canon log allows you to have a base ISO of 400, and Canon log 3 provides a base of ISO 800.
You may kiss the bride.
Congratulations. Ladies and gentlemen, you may applaud.
Okay, I think it's about time to shoot some footage of newlyweds, don't you? With the magic window, we get an idea of what the viewer experiences in VR. Frame up your shot in the magic window using this white curved rectangle. We can place our subjects near the center of the frame, but in VR, it's also good to place some of the action just outside of the center to encourage the viewer to look around. In this setup, John, come on over. The bride and the groom start apart from each other, so the viewer will have to turn their head to see each of them. This is a manual focus lens, meaning you have to set the focus yourself. By rotating the focus band left or right, you're going to notice that both lenses are driven simultaneously. Since there are two lenses on one mount, you may notice that at certain times, the focus might be set for one lens and not the other. That's why there's a left-right difference adjustment dial that's on the right side of the lens. Simply remove the weather seal right here, and from there, use a supplied hex key to rotate the dial left and right. That'll allow you to go in, make both lenses align together using the magnify function. Here are a couple more tips to get tack sharp focus. Firstly, set your aperture to f2.8. This allows you to isolate the area of focus from the background to show more contrast. And speaking of contrast, if you're using Canon log for your footage, I suggest disabling it while you're focusing. The higher contrast will make it easier for you to pull focus. There are two more tools that I want to talk to you about that are in the autofocus menu. The first one is manual focus peaking. With it, you can adjust it to be a color overlay that's customizable, where you can adjust both the color and the brightness level. When your subject is in focus, a glowing outline will appear over them. The second tool is Focus Guide, a popular feature borrowed from our Cinema EOS cameras. It provides a small focus box at the center of your image with indicators to show where your focus position is in relation to your subject. Turning the focus ring back and forth, the top and bottom indicators will move to indicate front or back focus. And there you have it. You're now ready for your first VR shoot. Between what you just learned and what you already know about filmmaking, in no time, you'll be creating awesome VR content of your own. Congratulations, you two.
Thank you.
Have fun out there.